efficient for carrying out your titration. Now you have to add FAI solution from the burette slowly to get the red point end point from bluish green to reddish brown. So before titration, you have to ensure whether the solution is at zero or the solution is at zero position. Now yes, it is at zero position. Now fix it to burette stand and add slowly drop by drop. Okay, I'm adding drop by drop potassium ferrous ammonium sulfate solution to the industrial waste water which is already oxidized by potassium dichromate. So add drop by drop slowly. So till how long we have to add? Till to change the color of the solution from bluish green to reddish brown. That is the end point. So during the titration, you can see the color gradually changes from bluish green and immediately it changes to reddish brown. So that is the end point. At that point, you have to stop adding ferrous ammonium sulfate solution. And if you can see, now the solution is slowly changing to bluish green. When you reach the end point, you have to add very carefully, drop by drop. Add one drop and shake it well. Add another drop, shake it well, and stop adding when the solution reaches to reddish brown color. So this is the reddish brown color. This is the end point of the reaction. I can add another one drop. Yes, this is the complete reddish brown color, stable reddish brown color. This is the end point. Now immediately auto record how much potassium, how much ferrous ammonium sulfate solution is consumed to neutralize this potassium dichromate. So now you have to read the burette, take the burette reading. It is showing 11.6. So the burette reading is 11.6. Okay, so now you have to write down the volume of FAS solution, ferrous ammonium sulfate consumed for the titration. You have to record in the tabular column given to you in the manual. All of you are having manual. In the tabular column, you have to write down so the volume of potassium ferrous ammonium sulfate consumed is how much? 11.6 cm³. So initial burette reading was 00. Now the volume of FAS solution consumed is 11.6. If I deduct 11.6 from 0, the answer is 11.6. So that is the volume of FAS consumed. Similarly, you have to carry out second trial, and similarly you have to carry out third trial. Three trials you have to carry out, then you can calculate what is the COD value from the formula given in the manual. COD of the sample is equal to the volume of FAS consumed in the blank titration minus the volume of FAS consumed in the sample titration and into normality of FAS into 8 × 1000 divided by volume of FAS solution consumed. As the formula is given in the manual, you have to calculate the COD value. I will show you how to calculate the COD value. Then we have to perform one blank titration also. For the blank titration, instead of FAS, instead of industrial wastewater,
we have to take 25 cm cube of distilled water. Then you have to add same 1 test tube of 1:1 sulfuric acid. We have to add 10 cm cube of K2Cl2O7 solution. We have to add 2 to 3 drops of ferrite indicator. In the same way, you have to titrate. Then you have to find out how much potassium dichromate is consumed for the blank titration. Usually, the potassium dichromate consumed in the blank titration will be more than the sample titration. So, that is blank titration value. Since it is constant for all the students, so we will provide the blank titration value for all of you. You need not carry out the blank titration in the regular class experiment, lab experiments, as well as in the examination. We will give you the blank titration value. So you have to carry out 3 trials of sample titration. You have to carry out, and you have to take the concordant value which you are going to get during the titration. So all of you understood. So first, what in summary, I'll tell you in a few lines. First, we have to prepare for determining industrial COD of industrial wastewater sample. First, you have to determine. First, you have to prepare standard FAS solution 250 cm cube. So, in a 250 cm cube volumetric glass, you have to prepare. For that, you need standard. For that, you need FAS crystals. Okay, ferrous ammonium sulfate crystals. Those crystals you have to weigh, take the weight of ferrous ammonium sulfate crystals and transfer the crystals into 250 cm cube volumetric glass, and you know the weight of ferrous ammonium sulfate crystals. You know you are adding water up to the mark, 250 cm cube distilled water, means you are dissolving a known weight of FAS in a known volume of distilled water. Okay, so then you can calculate the strength of the solution. Okay, the normality of the solution can be determined. The normality of the solution can be calculated by using weight of the FAS crystals taken multiplied by 4 divided by molecular weight of FAS crystals. The molecular weight of FAS crystals is given 392 grams. Then we are multiplying by 4, because if you are preparing the standard solution in 1 liter, you need not multiply by any factor. Since we are preparing in a 250 cm cube volumetric glass, 250 into 4, that makes 1000. 250 into 4 is equal to 1000. That means per, always we are going to calculate normality or molarity per dm cube of the solution. So this is the first part in the experiment, preparation of standard FAS solution, then transferring the standard FAS solution into the burette. The second part, you have to take the conical flask. To the conical flask, first you have to take 25 cm cube of industrial wastewater. You have to transfer. After transferring that, you have to add 1 test tube of 1:1 sulfuric acid from the test tube provided to you. Then you have to add 10 cm cube of potassium dichromate solution. This is the oxidizing agent. Then you have to add 2 to 3 drops of ferrite indicator for knowing the end point of the reaction by changing its color. It changes its color from bluish green to reddish brown. So you have to slowly titrate against the standard FAS solution drop by drop. When the color changes from bluish to reddish brown, immediately you have to stop the adding potassium ferrous ammonium sulfate solution. Then you have to record the burette reading in the manual. From the values obtained, you can calculate COD of the industrial wastewater. So you can see in the manual. So here in the manual, you have first weight of FAS.
Yes, in the calculation observation part, weight of weighing bottle plus FA is 9.786. You have taken that, you have to detect M2, you have to detect from M1 after transferring this salt into the 250 cm cube volumetric flask. Weight of empty weighing bottle is M2. M2 I am deducting from M1 minus 4.238. So that gives you 5.548. 5.548 is the weight of FAS, ferrous ammonium sulfate crystals transferred. Okay, so that is, okay, from that weight of FAS we can calculate the normality of FAS solution. Normality of Mohr salt solution is equal to weight of Mohr salt taken into 4 divided by equivalent weight of Mohr salt 392 grams. So weight of Mohr salt is the value of M1 minus M2, so that is 5.548. okay, into 4, I am multiplying that with 4, then I am dividing the value by 392. So I will get 0.0566 is the normality of the solution which we have prepared. So from that I have to write down the volume of FA solution consumed. This you have to take from the three concordant values. One value you have to take, okay, usually concordant value, otherwise the nearest least value you have to take. So that is 11.6 I will take here. Blank titer value today we have got, we will give you this 20 cm cube. Okay, then the calculation, 1000 cm cube of 1 molar 1 normal Mohr salt solution is equivalent to 1 equivalent of oxygen, that is 8 grams of oxygen. Therefore this strength Mohr salt is equivalent to, okay, x minus y, this is the x, so that is blank titer value, y is the sample titration burette reading, okay, dash normal, so 0.056, okay, normal Mohr salt solution contains how much milligrams of oxygen. So 8 into x value is 20, y value is 11.6, okay, into normality of FAS solution 0.0566 into 1000, calculate, we are calculating for 1 liter, divided by 25 is the volume of ferrous ammonium sulfate, is the volume of industrial wastewater solution taken for the titration. Okay, so now we will get 20 minus 11.6, that gives you 8.4 into 8 into multiplied by 0.0566 normality of FAS multiplied by 1000, and the whole value is divided by 25. Now you will get the answer 152.14 milligrams of oxygen, milligrams of oxygen per dm cube of the solution. So this is the result we'll get, means the industrial wastewater sample, it requires 152.14 milligrams of oxygen per liter to oxidize completely the waste impurities into the products carbon dioxide and water. This is how we can determine the COD of the given industrial wastewater sample. So as I gave the demonstration, in the same way you can also carry out and you can also find out what is the
COD of the given industrial wastewater for you in the lab. Okay, so in the if you have any doubts, leave your doubts in the comment box. And if you don't have any doubts, you like the video and share the video for all your friends. Thank you.